In this world, you've gotta be strong. You've gotta fight to keep your spirit alive. And you might feel like there's nothing left to go for if I fall. But it's the fight that keeps us ready and on guard. Even now, I can feel the power. When I think of him, I see no fear. Feel no pain. This, surprisingly, is not some hip new age Christian rock, but instead the theme song to one of Nintendo's C-list icons, Captain Douglas J. Falcon. Originally created to be the mascot of the Super Famicom to go hand in hand with the hot new F-Zero series he'd be starring in, Captain Falcon is a character who's languished in obscurity compared to the lofty hopes promised by his debut. While heavily acclaimed, the high-speed F-Zero series has laid dormant since 2004, Falcon's biggest claim to fame being his consistent role as a fighter in the Super Smash Bros. Series. And yet, despite his lengthy absence from games, in spite of being one of the most obscure characters on a roster of over 80 fighters, Captain Falcon has persisted. Come on! He's become a meme with his various catchphrases and strong personality, ingraining himself so deeply into the culture of Smash Brothers that the game just wouldn't feel the same without him. If anything, Falcon has grown to be even more beloved than his entire series, an irreplaceable part of Nintendo's cast, in spite of F-Zero's shine long since being forgotten. And you have to wonder, why is that? What makes Falcon endure past the Ice Climbers, Little Max, and Min Mins of the world into feeling so immediately likable? Well, listen. Captain Falcon is more than just another face on a fighting game roster or a design that happened to be picked as the face of a racing franchise. He's the very soul of that high-octane racing franchise. When he fights, he's meticulously designed to exude the feel of that series. And in character, he's this unshakable daredevil, a peerless showman, always ready to one-up himself and take on the next impossible challenge with a smile. Players gravitate toward Captain Falcon because of his style, skill, and strength, but all of that comes down to one simple philosophy. Captain Falcon is a character who was born to exceed all limitations. And everyone who plays with or as him is encouraged to do the same.
Show me your moves!
Three, two, 1, go!
F-Zero is a futuristic racing series that got its start on the Super Famicom in 1990. Conceptualized as how Formula One races would look in the 26th century, F-Zero plays a great deal of homage to its real-life counterpart. Formula One races are all about making the fastest vehicles possible duke it out in tricky tracks where your vehicle's durability, intelligent cornering, and split-second decision-making determines who crosses the finish line. Set dressing aside, there are only three major deviations between F1 and F0. First, pit stops have been swapped for these healing strips, changing the necessary process of rapid manual repairs into yet another split-second decision of whether healing up for a moment is worth it compared to maintaining your lead in racing lines. Second, starting on lap 2, F-Zero racers gain the ability to turbo boost.
You got boost power!
Letting them sacrifice the well-being of their vehicle for a reckless burst of speed. And finally, while hitting other racers is discouraged and can result in penalties in F1, F-Zero doesn't just encourage it, it glorifies the act of violence, goading on all racers to kill as many of their fellow competitors as possible. These simple changes take the F1 idea of carefully playing around your opponent and choosing the best time to pass with crafty maneuvers and better vehicle maintenance, and adds on a significantly more aggressive, death-defying, and death-causing set of teeth to each race. Your speed, position, and survivability are all carefully interconnected in F-Zero, and it's hard.
Too bad! You lost your machine!
F-Zero is a really demanding series, requiring players to keep full knowledge of the track, their health, their handling, and the racers around them in order to succeed, with a far smaller and far more punishing margin for error than Mario Kart or Super Hang-On would allow for. But in spite of all of F-Zero's challenge and nuance, it's conquerable. Tracks that once totally thrashed you can be tackled again with a fresh perspective and lessons learned. You start to learn when to boost and when to brake, what straightaways you can safely go for an attack on and which will kill you in the process, how much life you can give to go at ludicrous speeds without blowing yourself up. And through it all, Captain Falcon is right there to power through with the player and help them taste that sweet, sweet victory.
Yes!
His machine, the Blue Falcon, is incredibly well-rounded, featuring above-average durability, handling, and weight, along with an average boost that trades a bit of max speed for the ability to control the dang vehicle while rocketing around. This makes him the ideal choice for both learning tracks and then later handling their difficult sections with ease, still being able to blast past rivals in a thrilling last-second dash without being totally outclassed. The learning curve with Captain Falcon behind the wheel is just that much easier compared to the wild and reckless or slow and steady rides a player could otherwise latch onto. Heck, due to his average boost power but good durability and turning, it's very likely that the Blue Falcon will be in good shape toward the end of a race as it maneuvers around corners, giving Falcon the chance to try to turbo down that final straightaway freely and nab first place. In that way, Captain Falcon is a true thrill seeker, designed to be able to handle the nastiest part of a course and having just enough of a speed boost to practically ensure a photo finish. Any supposed weaknesses just making that final stretch that much more thrilling. Plus, he's got a pretty appealing design compared to middle-aged Tails, Band in Chile, and Pink Grandma. It's not like you're picking Mario and Mario Kart when you go Falcon. It's pretty cool. In a series with a collection of freaks, thugs, and weirdos, Captain Falcon truly feels like a hero, with a stat spread that encourages players to feel the same as they steadily improve. And in the brutal, breakneck world of F-Zero, nothing is more satisfying than being able to show off your skills while maintaining the devil-may thrill of a near-death miracle win.
You don't win by being lucky. You win by being bold.
Ready? Go!
So, cool. The Blue Falcon's a really solid racing vehicle that helps new players get into the way past fast gameplay. Alright. That doesn't explain how a race car driver who never even appeared outside of his vehicle in-game before Smash, outside of art splashes on the character select screen, became one of the most beloved brawlers in one of the largest crossover fighting franchises. Against all odds and his incredible obscurity, Captain Falcon's remained one of the most enduring faces of Super Smash Bros. As a whole, appearing in nearly as many fighters as he's had main entries into his own series.
Whoops.
So what makes him stand out from this crowd of heroes, weirdos, and legends alike? What makes the man one of the most hype of all in Smash? Well, He hits and moves like the race cars he pilots, for starters. Captain Falcon boasts the second fastest run speed in the entire series, along with high marks in airspeed, weight, jump height, and fall speed. This effectively ensures that wherever Captain Falcon is going, he's getting there fast. Trying to outrace an opponent to a destination that he himself smashed them to before they can come to their senses. His speed is coupled with absolutely brutal power, with Falcon having some of the most dynamic and harsh spikes in the game, combined with explosive moves designed to carry an opponent right off the horizontal blast zone. However, Falcon historically lacks excellent options when coming out of shielding, and his initial walking speed is among the slowest in the game. A sedentary Falcon is one with clipped wings.
Oh no!
To play Falcon effectively, players must keep on moving, ready to burst out at any moment, punishing any mistake or opening their opponent leaves with a flurry of moves that one way or another, someone is gonna die from. And that is exactly how Falcon operates in F-Zero. Trying to stay out of your opponent's range, holding your boost until just the right moment, maneuvering around stages with tight bursts of speed, rocketing in and netting the kill at your foe's most vulnerable moment, that is an F-Zero race to a T. And it's perfectly translated into Captain Falcon's moveset. Three of Falcon's four special moves are burst movement options, designed to close in on and take advantage of a vulnerable opponent, and continue Falcon's furious offense. He's got an excellent up air that's perfect for juggling an opponent, and his incredible movement speed allows him to keep up with even the trickiest movement patterns. He's got
the knee,
an aerial with a very small sweet spot that utterly devastates anyone it comes into contact with. Designed exclusively to be the finishing blow of an all-out offensive. And best of all of Falcon's tools, all of these great moves are completely fair and honest. Every single one of Captain Falcon's moves is without a gimmick. He's got a little bit of armor on Raptor Boost here and a sweet spot there, but there's nothing in Falcon's toolkit that counters the opponent's moves, or has a meter or a charge or even a projectile to limit the opponent's movement. Captain Falcon fights every single character on the roster at their full strength, with nothing to overcome them but fundamentals accelerated to the highest caliber. On paper, there's not a single character in Smash with a less varied overall moveset than Captain Falcon. But all he needs is skill. Captain Falcon pushes anyone who plays him to be the absolute best they can, to get into the minds of their opponent and outmaneuver them, to learn the basics of whatever Smash game he's in and weaponize it as lethally as possible. And without anything more flashy than good movement, Falcon gives his players every tool they need to utterly dominate the competition. No character is historically more thrilling to see in action than Captain Falcon. One good read, one explosive combo, one lethal string of knees can turn a match on its head instantly. Falcon is a character that you can never count out, as even if he's horribly behind, it only takes that one moment of gotcha for him to mount his comeback. In every single game where Falcon is even remotely viable, he has always risen to prominence the better players get at the game, as his ability to reward pure technique remains utterly unparalleled. Captain Falcon is a character without a ceiling, one that pushes himself and every one of his players forward to meet their limits and find a way to surpass them. He's not just the embodiment of F-Zero, he's the embodiment of self-improvement, of having all the tools you need from the very beginning and coming to realize just how to use him. And the people love him for it.
That's it!
Let's go!
But all of that leaves one question. If everything's so fast, explosive, and made to quickly hit an opponent's weakness, what's the Falcon Punch supposed to be? A slow, predictable, easily punishable strike that doesn't even have armor? Why is this move hailed with such reverence when it doesn't complement Falcon's kit and other really strong strikes aren't given nearly the same respect? To answer that, I have to take a step back from Super Smash Bros. And look at something slightly less volatile and slightly more ridiculous. Professional wrestling. No, don't go. I have a point.
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking?
This is The Rock. You might know him because he's The Rock.
You're welcome.
A 10-time WWE World Champion, Rocky is absolutely beloved by fans for his explosive offense and utterly electrifying charisma. And when The Rock is ready to put an opponent away, the Great One has a choice of two finishing moves. For a quick finish, Dwayne can pull out the Rock Bottom, a front-falling slam where The Rock hurdles The Rock's victim forward with the full force of The Rock's body, leaving them dazed and confused with a devastating-sounding thud. This is an incredibly practical finishing move. It feels incredibly powerful with the high-flying bodies and the resounding crash of muscle. It's dynamic enough that it commands attention whenever it comes out, and it's quick enough that The Rock can pull it out as a counter as a surprise finish if the time is right, or can use the rest of his skill set to build up to it as The Rock's grand finale. This is the Knee of Justice for Captain Falcon. An incredibly powerful, high-intensity move that just feels good to hit and is the likeliest method of closing out stocks. Most Falcon combos yearn to end with a knee strike into the horizon. The skill required to pull it off is instantly notable to casual viewers with its incredibly tight sweet spot window. And the power? Well, that speaks for itself. It's a good, reliable, and decently hype finishing move. But we can do better. The Rock has a second finisher, one that surpasses The Rock Bottom in pure hype and grandiose status. Because when Rocky really wants to rile up the crowd, the champ lays the smackdown with the people's elbow. And this isn't just an attack, it's a ceremony. To begin, The Rock stands above a prone candy-ass victim, taking in the crowd. Discarding The Rock's right armband, holding back the power of the most electrifying elbow in sports entertainment. The Rock bounds off of the ropes twice, leaping gracefully over The Rock's opponent, before stopping right before them, lifting The Rock's leg to grandstand and delay the impact, then slamming the people's elbow right through the heart or solar plexus of The Rock's victim. It is an incredibly stupid move. Adding 6 to 9 seconds to a basic elbow drop for The Rock's opponent to catch their breath. It could be easily countered by just scooching a little bit in that time. It's not even that technically impressive and definitely shouldn't be considered a match ender. But crowds go absolutely wild for this thing. There's so much showmanship to the people's elbow that when a crowd realizes that everything is lined up perfectly for the move, their excitement is uncontrollable as they see a hapless victim and the spark in The Rock's eyes that tell them, yeah, The Rock's going for it. And the pageantry of it all. Shared connection between performer and audience, the thrill that builds from the armband leaving The Rock's body to the explosion of excitement that is the final elbow drop, lets a crowd feel and believe that this noodle-armed bash is the most powerful blow in the entire world. The Falcon Punch is Captain Falcon's people's elbow. It's an insanely powerful attack, but only a fool would throw it out and hope for the best. A Captain Falcon maid needs to be truly outplaying their opponent and getting in their head in order to land the flaming fist. But there's no better move in the game to make a statement with. The slow windup, the glow, the scream of
Falcon!
everyone, from the Falcon player to their opponent to every spectator, knows what's coming. And that small pause builds up the same jolt of excitement as the people's elbow. The desire to see if Falcon's foe can avoid this called shot. And when it lands, there's no gimmick to explain why or excuse to be made. Everyone knows that someone absolutely got blown up. With Falcon Punch's placement as a special move, Captain Falcon can provide that call out at any time, from any position, using all of the tools at his disposal to set up into it. Falcon Punch is one of the most free-form, impractical moves in all of Smash. And the theatricality, the power, the setup needed, and the sheer improbability of the move landing combine to make it one of the most crowd-pleasing and fulfilling attacks possible. And that is the final key to Captain Falcon's kit. Showmanship.
Yeah!
You're not just improving on a purely technical level with Falcon. He gives you all the tools necessary to make the impossible possible. To call shots that no other character would dare to call. To push yourself beyond simply being the best. That's why confirms like Melee's Sacred Combo, a powerful string ending in a true combo to a Falcon Punch, are so sought after. Everyone is willing to get lost in the hype for just a moment for this one perfectly placed move. Captain Falcon wants you to surpass your opponent so far that you send a message and gives you the most explosive tool he can to do that with.
Yes! 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 Falcon! Punch!
Yeah! The final lap!
So, from a technical level, Captain Falcon's pretty fantastic. But he refuses to stop there. On a character level, on the core of what he is, Falcon still motivates players to achieve all they can. And the central reason for this is, well, he's just designed to be cool. The original F-Zero was heavily inspired in character and design from Batman. Director Kazunobu Shimizu being inspired by Tim Burton's Batman movie and the comics released in the same time to make the F-Zero universe as cool as possible. When this American comics-influenced design was put into Smash, it mixed with another incredibly popular medium for inspiration, tokusatsu. All of Captain Falcon's moves have a very distinctive oomph to them. A momentum that feels like it's taken directly out of Super Sentai, or more accurately, Kamen Rider. Falcon's two signature techniques, the Falcon Punch and Falcon Kick, are ripped right from Kamen Rider's famous finishers.
Rider! Jeez!
This makes Falcon a unique blend of Eastern and Western ideas of cool, making him a brawler with nearly universal appeal, and perhaps more importantly, a superhero that can be understood as such no matter what culture you're from. The F-Zero series only continues to flesh him out as the biggest and strongest. And even though most of the games give him little to work with character-wise, you know this Judge Dredd-looking Red Ranger style and Man Among Men is gonna carry you through. And then in F-Zero GX... oh boy. Captain Falcon goes into his secret Batcave dedicated to racing to beat his high score and then immediately goes to his rival Samurai Goro's Bandit Canyon to beat him as his own Death Rock Slide course. After entering an underground race in disguise, Falcon kills an entire gang of race car thugs in an impromptu
death race,
then zooms directly into an exploding building, saves Jody Summers, who is blonde now for some reason while he's there, and outraces the already exploding because of terrorism building with a literal second to spare. Then Black Shadow puts puts Falcon in
electric death ball.
And Blood Falcon makes him reenact the movie Speed with Keanu Reeves, but 10 times faster. After which Falcon decides screw it and wins the entire F-Zero Grand Prix and ends terrorism. But
the devil
comes and kills Black Shadow and brings Captain Falcon to hell in order to race him. So Captain Falcon beats him and becomes the Hell Champion and kills the devil. But then Falcon has the world and the Hell Belt and they combine so that God shows up and challenges Captain Falcon to a race for the concept of free will. So Captain Falcon goes,
"You think you can beat me? No way."
Directly in God's face, beats God, banishes God to the Shadow Realm, and goes for a walk while the credits sing about how cool he is. So that's nuts. And F-Zero GX is nuts. Like, it's crazy hard. It's story mode notoriously brutally difficult. But through every challenge, the player is motivated to move forward, to see what ludicrous thing Captain Falcon is gonna pull off next. And they personally know how insane all this stuff Falcon's pulling off is, because they have to complete it for themselves and can feel how tough it is. They need to get good in order to get on Falcon's level. And that is one of the coolest bits of motivation I've ever seen. You don't just get to feel like Captain Falcon, incredibly badass hero for free. You have to earn it. You have to learn and inherit the skill that the character naturally has in order to live up to his constant feeling of success. And in trying over and over again to be worthy of the Falcon name, players care about this ridiculous, incredible super race car driver. Captain Falcon is the idealized form of your skill, as you earn the right to see the rest of his story play out. He is the coolest guy! And so are you.
Show me a moose!
That is the heart of Falcon. His undying, inheritable spirit. In F-Zero GP Legend, a 52-episode anime about F-Zero, Captain Falcon is described as less of a man and more of a primordial force for good. There is one physical Captain Falcon in the world who does the cool racing things and fights villains, but the strength of Captain Falcon exists beyond the body of Andy Summer. The most famous scene of the anime is its climax, where Captain Falcon delivers a Falcon Punch to Black Shadow and seemingly blows up the entire galaxy with pure manliness. Most will point out that this is just a regular punch. Falcon hit Black Shadow into an already exploding reactor of galactic dark energy or something. But I feel that just adds more to the moment. This massive explosion wasn't from Captain Falcon being some kind of almighty god of machismo with infinite power. He's just one man, using all of his strength, all of his life's energy, to see his righteous ambition through. The anime ends with Rick Wheeler, a newcomer to the series, inheriting the mantle of Captain Falcon after witnessing his predecessor's sacrifice. And that is the note GP Legend leaves us on. Anyone can push hard enough to make the impossible a reality. Anyone can fight the good fight and shake galaxies if they try hard enough. There will always be a Captain Falcon. Anyone can be Captain Falcon. F-Zero has always been a series about surpassing limits. The SNES game was made to showcase Mode 7 technology and show the sheer power of the hardware. F-Zero X was made to have 30 vehicles charging forward at a rock-solid 60 frames per second at a time where that was thought to be near impossible. F-Zero GX? I mean, look at it! This shouldn't be possible on a GameCube! Every single time, the series was up to the task of pushing further beyond. And in all of his fighting game appearances, not you, so was Captain Falcon.
Come on!
Falcon pushed both F-Zero and Smash Brothers to their limits in terms of fundamentals. and in turn, they gave him character that became the embodiment of that fearless fighting spirit. And in all of his appearances, he invites all players to do the same and show him their moves. Falcon isn't a deep character in the traditional sense, but I find he's incredibly important for the medium of video games. Here's a character who represents everything that a player could be, thoroughly idealized into a superheroic, instantly appealing form, who represents all of a player's success after toiling again and again to improve. He's a character that could only work as well as he does through the medium of video games. And the stories he crafts aren't just for his own benefit, they're stories of your growth, as you invest yourself in his races, into his fights, into Captain Falcon. He's an undying spirit that I sincerely hope will continue to appear in games, even as he fades further from the spotlight. Because we need more Captain Falcons in this world. We need more characters and experiences to push players to exceed all limitations.
See you again!